Kia ora, I'm Smitner, and I want to show you how I made these pixel-perfect tentacles for my dark puzzle game, Hazard Pay. I'm going to cover how I made the base tentacle, the rest will be up to you. Check out the description for access to the source code, feel free to follow along, as each file name will appear on the bottom right of the screen. Jumping straight in, we're going to use the Line 2D node as our foundation, setting a base color, drawing some points. I'm adding a curve resource to the width property to control the thickness of our arm, and then rounding everything off. Getting this thing pixelated is pretty trivial. Create a sub viewport and container, and just throw the line 2D inside. While we're here, let's have it follow the mouse. Next up, let's explore FABRIK, an inverse kinematics technique which is perfect for a tentacle, as we don't need joint limits. Say we have this line. Here's the base, tip, and target. We first move the tip to the target. In a backwards pass over each segment, we calculate the direction between the two joints and multiply that by the desired segment length. After re-anchoring the base, we continue with the forward pass, calculating the direction between the two joints and multiplying by the segment length again. This process simply repeats for as many times as you want. The more it iterates, the more accurate the result. FABRIK works, but it's a bit stiff. To give this thing a life of its own, let's have a look at waves. Our sine wave is made out of three main components: amplitude, or the height of the wave, frequency, how many waves, and finally, speed. For each segment, we get the direction along the arm as before, calculate the perpendicular vector, and then move the joint by calculating the offset between it and the sine wave. Breaking that down, each segment gets a normalized position from 0 to 1, the base being 0, middle segments in between, and the tip 1. We take that normalized position value and multiply it by the wave frequency to get the phase of the wave in relation to the segment. To get the offset, we pass in our wave phase into the sine function, which returns a range between negative and positive 1. Multiplying this value by amplitude gives us the distance we need to travel. Finally, using our perpendicular vector as a direction and our distance offset, we can update the position of the joint. This continues for all segments, updating each joint. Shadows. A shadow is simply another line 2D with the same properties as the existing one, tracking its motion with an offset. The trick for a convincing effect is to interpolate between a minimum and maximum offset to create the illusion of height, as if the tip is sitting higher from the ground. But there's one issue with our shadows: they overlap with each other. Lucky for us, we have a versatile node called Canvas Group. So let's put the shadow line underneath. The canvas group will render all children in a single draw operation, and this is exactly what we need to prevent the overdraw. Using the documented shader example as a base, let's take all non-transparent pixels and recolor them with our shadow color. Outlines. For pixel-perfect outlines, we want to add a shader on top of our sub-viewport container. Thankfully, as I'm no shader wizard, I found one on GodotShaders.com from Jake Mike Mill. This shader actually supports shadows, so by adjusting the alpha threshold, we can remove the incorrect shadow outline from the sub-viewport texture. Have a play with the other values to get something you like. I personally like my outlines with 4 neighbors and 1 pixel thick. Now we're cooking. But we need shading. I'm after a two-tone shader to give the arm some depth with fake lighting. You may be tempted to slap on a Gradient 2D and call it a day. The main issue with this approach is that the shading isn't oriented to the world. It's oriented to the UV space of each line segment. We need a world-oriented two-tone shader that shades in relation to the arm thickness. But as a mere shader apprentice, I was stumped. I turned to the shader oracle Claude and was shown the way forward.
Can a robot turn a canvas into a beautiful masterpiece?
Can you?
The shader first looks up until an edge is found, and then the same for looking down. The total height of the arm is calculated, and a configurable shade width scaler applied. The shader then looks if it went down below the shade threshold and colors the pixels either light or dark. Now, adjusting the shade ratio, we can control where the shade begins until we get the look we're after. And there we have it. World-oriented, two-tone shaded, pixel-perfect, organic-feeling, creepy but cute, tentacle arm. Thank you for watching. Download the project and have a play. If you liked the video, do the thing. And check out my upcoming game, Hazard Pay. All links will be in the description. Till next time.